Hello everyone, welcome to Bargain Gaming, where we can play excellent games without busting our wallets. This is episode 2 of 7 Days to Die, and we need to navigate to, I think we're at bottom, we start at the bottom of the map, so we need to navigate by following this road. Hopefully it will lead someplace that we can actually, that can lead us to. Wait, this is north, right? Okay, let's go north. And then we need to come to a big road, because a big road usually will lead to civilization. Ooh, that's the squealing of a pig. Or, wow, fantastic. Oop, this is what I'm talking about. This is a small plant, and when we trip over that one, it's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt real bad. Okay, so fantastic. That is a hotel. Okay, let's get in there and let's make ourselves comfortable. Oh, we have not fulfilled the first quest yet, right? They're asking us to manufacture. What do you call this? Manufacture our clothes. Again, pressing square, we get to the crafting menu. Then using R1, using R3, we navigate to the clothes section. So here we need to make a plant fiber hat. We can do that, because that was part of the mission. And then a plant fiber hood. A plant fiber pants, a plant fiber shirt, and a plant fiber shoes. Okay, and then the shoulder button allows us to navigate to the character menu. So in the character menu, what we can do is just again highlight this and then press down on R3, and we automatically equip that one. That's the control, fast speed control. Oh, shortcut. Controller shortcuts. Focusing, okay, highlighting. No, I mean hovering over that. Put on pants. Put on shirt. Put on shoes. Now, these things, when we highlight them, it shows us that they offer insulation. What we don't need at this point in time is insulation. We're getting hot. We actually need, like the hat, this hat offers us negative insulation, -8. So this cools us down. So glasses and masks help cool us down too. So now if we can find glasses and hats, that will help us cool down. But okay, let's, you know, we have not been picking up much stones. Yeah, I didn't pick up more food. We will need these. No, not that yucca plant. Oh, okay. Let's beat up on this stone. We need stones, right? By beating up on the smaller stone, when you see this, this will break the stones. They go three stages. Every time we break up something, let's try to make sure we break it all the way through, because right now we're getting like one each, right? One metal and one stone. But when we break it, watch it, we will get a sudden, oh, we got 5 metals and 11 stones. So keep breaking all the way through. There's always like a bonus at the end if we go all the way through. Again, one each. One. And our stone axe is degrading very fast. It's only level 1. But anyway, see, once we hit that, okay, we got the bonus. Let's just break it. That's okay, because we got fibers, we got stones, and we got wood. And also, there's a small wood in this area. There are no trees in this area. They're just cactuses. So, okay, now we can build another. So, again, the left and the right trigger allows us to move from these categories, and then we go to stone axe. And here we can actually press, I think, by, okay, now we can, okay, now we can arm this again. Okay. See, these things usually give us something. Apparently not. Okay. Let's finish this stone so we can get some stones in our inventory. And let me show you where we can get wood in this area. Ouch. Okay. Woods are little like you will see them right on the roadside. Let's try. Nothing. Wow, we're maxing out on our inventory. Wow. So we can disassemble cars. Wow, great. Great. Now we need all we need now, this little thing are purses or backpacks, and they're full of good stuff. Okay, let us break in this door right now. Wow. That's some door. Wow. And we're getting some wood. So we need to crash this, break through it, and then we can maybe camp for the night. Good thing we found this. I'm very happy we found this. This is an apartment complex right in the middle of nowhere. We will not do that first. Let us see if we can. Let's again square for the crafting, and then let's go to using the left and right trigger. We can go to the house area, and then sometimes like this when we're in this page, using the R3, we can move. So if there are more items that are in that screen, so there are so many things we can craft in the building. Right now, we want to craft a wood frame. So pressing X, that's what we will craft. Do we have enough wood? Yes. Okay, now focusing on that one and then pressing. So it goes through our tool belt. To navigate through our tool belt using the left or right shoulder buttons, the R1. And so that gives you an outline as to where those things can be placed. And remember, primary action is the right trigger. This is the secondary action, they call it. So using the left trigger, we put it down. And then let's make a chest, a secure chest. Again, pressing X highlights that one. So that's a chest. So we can, by pressing triangle, the up triangle, pressing and hold, huh? Press and hold to lock it or. No. Sorry. Okay, let's make it. Let's make the chest. Okay, it's done. Again, R3, pressing down. Now, by navigating to it using R1, see, we can now place it on top of the frame. Left trigger sets it down. Now we can put all the stuff we found here. Especially the meat, because right now we don't have zombies wandering us, or we turned zombies off, so we're not worried about having zombies going after. Oh, we picked up a pistol. Cool. So that's fine. And let's. Okay. And we can put this thing here and this thing here. Okay, now let's go look for. Let's look for trees. See these things, these little knots, these are trees. These are wood, actually, not trees. They're like dried up trees. So those are things we look for that will provide wood. The nice thing about this biome is that aside from the food, the nests or birds' nests are easily seen. They're very visible. Now I'm heading in that direction because you see water there. So apparently the novice game map is consistent because I've seen this, like I said, in my first playthrough, or one of my playthroughs where I died, where I spawned in the desert biome. It was here. And so again, that sneaky cactus there. Okay, now this is dirty water, right? Oh, where did I put? Oh, I did not bring those. Jeez, I put it in the. I put the glasses, the glass in the box. Okay, let's get more wood here. Okay, I think we're doing great because we found glass jars. And the desert biome is actually an easier place to start with. And okay, let us get. You know what? So this hand axe can also repair items. So by pressing L3, we can upgrade it, repair or upgrade it. So we'll upgrade it. The thing is, as a box, as a wooden frame, we can might. If we press here with the with that thing focused on the wooden frame, if we press X, we would have picked up the wood frame, and it will cause this chest to drop and shatter. In effect, all the stuff that we picked up and put in the chest will be gone. Okay, so that's why. But this way, now we cannot pick it up. Okay, let's have this. Have this. Okay. Now, okay. Wow, I'm really, really happy we started here. Okay. Now let's take a slightly different route so we can pick up more stuff. Like maybe we can find more nests and yucca plants. Is that the nest we looted? Nope, a new nest. Okay, now we go to the water. So with the water targeted, we can use our wa shoulder button to navigate to the empty. So we're holding up an empty jar, right? Now using L3, the secondary action, we will fill this. We will fill this. We will not be drinking that water. It's muddy water. Again, L3. Okay. Okay, now we can bring it back. Okay, let's continue to explore. Might as well pick up some more food. And in this area where it's darker, yeah, usually the yucca plants are plenty. Grow close together. I don't know how to talk, man. Sorry about that. I can't even talk. See, we will loot the hotel in our own good time at night when the zombies come out and we are staying indoors and hunkering down because yeah, I've not come out at night yet, so I don't know. I know we turn it off, right? But that's spawning, so that means they won't. Sp what if? What if the map already came with zombies? What I know is that the buttons. Oop, that's a pig. That's the sound of a pig that has actually accidentally. Oh, that has accidentally. What do you call this? Stumbled on a cactus. We need more wood and stones. Wow. Well, it's already 11:50 game time. So we have not yet we haven't made any fiber gloves. That is part of our mission. Okay. Now what we need to do now is find a cooking pot so that we can boil the water and then okay, so that the muddy water can become distilled water. We need gloves, right? He says we need gloves. Yes, gloves. Okay, now we have accomplished that. Let's go to our. What am I doing? Going to our. Yeah, character menu. Let's put on the gloves. Okay. Now we need. Yeah, after this, we need to find more wood. Oh, we haven't done a fiber hood too. So they want us to do a fiber hood. So again, navigating through that screen, we use the R2 or the left trigger or the right trigger, and then pressing up on the D-pad confirms that we want to make it. We need to gather more wood and stone so that at night when we are doing nothing or we're hunkered down waiting for daylight to come, we can actually build more hand axes. So again, when you look, okay, pressing R, so we can navigate. This is the character screen, right? And this is the map screen. Further down, we will see that there are so many things that we can buy. Every time we level up, we get, I think, 5 points, which we can use to buy some of these stuff. So these are the things that we can buy, and these are the points that we need to spend. Okay. So what's now? Plant fiber hood. Yeah. Oh, wear plant fiber hood. Okay, we did not wear it. Let's wear it, and then we will give. They'll give us a new. Oh, we made two hoods already. What? Whoa. Okay, let's go to the character screen. Okay, we wore it, but we're in the desert. We don't want to do that. So, did they give us a new gather wood 5 and then craft wooden club? So, let's gather wood. Let's gather wood. He wants us to gather more wood. We will gather more wood. Eggs. Oh, those are good. I love eggs. We need more wood. Those little knotty things lying on the ground. I'm not seeing them. Press again, press. Oh, yeah, he's just right beside me. I can't even see it. Okay. So, pressing triangle allows us to loot stuff. Okay, like this. We're picking up that stuff. We need more eggs. Okay. Those knotty things on the ground, come on. Okay. Wow, eggs. I'm not seeing any wood. Okay, that thing here. Wow, they produce so little stuff, little wood. The reason what I want to do is, okay, what do they want us to do? Gather wood. So we got 5. Create a wooden club. Okay. Okay. Go to the weapons menu. Now we can make a wooden club. That's our wooden club. This is a reinforced, that's a better club than this. Let us put this on. So, okay, we've done that. So we'll just get this back. Just throw it, we don't need it. And then what do we need? Craft armor, huh? Craft arrow, okay. Craft wooden bow, okay. Wood, yeah. It's almost, hey, it's 12 o'clock, how come? Usually there is an airdrop. And we put our airdrops at every day. There should be an airdrop. I'm not seeing any airdrop. Airdrops is in the form of a plane coming down, and it will drop a box. And we got it, we allowed, or we took the option of it being marked for us, that the airdrop will be marked on our the upper part where you see at the top part of the screen. It will show where the airdrop was, because it will if we did not pick that option, after a few, you know, we have to actually physically mark it on the map and remember where it dropped. So that's no fun. Again, like I said, this is a tutorial, and so we're just learning how to play this game. Okay, we need more stones. Okay, and I think this episode is getting getting up there, so I might have to cut it pretty soon. So we're not seeing any boulders, right? There's a problem with this biome. Oh, that's a chicken. Wait, where did? Oh, we're way past it. So that square thing over here, that's our hotel. Let's go back down. Let's go east. And here is another piece of wood. We need wood and we need stones, because we need to make arrows. Making arrows is one of the quickest way to get our weapon skills, on our weapon making skills up. Like this stone axe is a tool skill. Making stone axes will increase our tool making skill. Making arrows will improve our weapon making skills. Well, that's okay. Ooh, what's that? Wow. So we need stones. So like the bow, we will have to make the bow, right? And the bow will represent weapon making skill. So we will do that when in the evening hours. Well, we can do that now, because it wants us to do that, right? I don't know. We're about to run out of axe again. So let's make one. Let's make two. Before we make the arrows. And since arrows, so let's just max out, right? Wow, we can make 127 arrows. So it will take some time to finish the arrows. That's why I made two more stone axes, because I'm pretty sure we will break them. Because so it's in a queue right now. So if we break another stone axe, we will have to stop this, so that and we want to make a stone axe, we'll have to stop this on the queue, because so that the stone axe will come in. Okay, I guess it's time to cut the episode right here. Thank you guys for joining me. I hope you will join me in the next episode. Bye.